Good afternoon. It's Daryl Freeman with Cockpit Conversations, and I am here with my co-pilot today, Dion Allen. We just left watching his daughter play basketball, the Catamounts.
Yep. Catamounts, and Western Carolina University.
Western Carolina University. It just seems like yesterday that she was
1 month old.
Or, yeah.
And now she's almost 22. That means we're both getting older. So, in this cockpit conversation, I'm talking to my fraternity brother, Dion Allen, member of Omega Psi Phi, pledged in the spring of 1980.
Yes,
and
sir.
My name is Daryl Freeman, of course, and I pledged in the spring of 84. So, we've both been in the fraternity probably a combined for almost 40.
Yep.
And 30-something for me, so 70-something years of Omega right here in the cockpit. Then we got our wives back there in the back. They're probably napping a little bit. So, Dion, tell the audience what Omega Psi Phi means to you.
Well, Omega Psi Phi means friendship to me. I mean, you know, we always talk about friendship is essential to the soul, but what you have to think about is that, you know, once I crossed and pledged the fraternity, those bonds that I created, even while pledging with my other three Lion brothers, but the bond of the big brothers then, those bonds still are relevant today. I remember individuals like Wendell Porter and Larry Hurt, who are older than me.
Okay, 567 Echo Romeo, we're at discretion down to 1-2000 Echo Romeo.
Go ahead, Dan. I'm sorry. I still got to fly the plane a little bit.
Wendell Porter and Larry Hurt, we're still friends today. I mean, you know, if I go to Atlanta, you know, I always got a place to stay. If I go to Chad, I always have a place to stay. It's that, those type of friendships that you build throughout the fraternity. That's what I love about the fraternity.
So when I pledged Omega Psi Phi in 1984, you were a big brother of mine, somebody I aspired to be like. We talked about our wives being in the back. You've been married almost 40 years?
Maybe 30. It'll be 35 years
in
July.
35 years. I've been married 27 years. You've been a mentor and a friend. You talk about Omega Psi Phi and its buns. You've been very helpful to me in my career. And then watching you and how you treat your wife and how you raise Angel and how you've been traveling all across the country to watch her play basketball. But Omega Psi Phi, the first quarter principle is manhood, and I think for those newer members coming into fraternity, understanding what manhood really means, and what does that mean to you?
Well, manhood, I think we talked about that the last time. Manhood is really being a provider. Being a provider for your family, you know, having that uplift for the individuals that you come in contact with, being a role model and example for individuals to help them throughout their life so they can, you know, aspire to be not what you are, but more than what you are.
Got it. And so at our chapter, Mu Zeta, Middle Tennessee State University, in the 80s, our graduation rate was 90+%. And one of the things that made me stay in college, even though I was a terrible student, was I was a member of Omega Psi Phi, and I didn't want to leave because Omega had become like a family to me. And also, I didn't want to leave because I knew that we had such a high graduation rate. I did not want to ruin that. So.
Echo Romeo, contact Memphis Center 128.15. Good night.
Hey, thanks for being here. 2815 Echo Romeo.
But I didn't want to ruin the graduation rate, and so I stuck it out and stayed.
We're glad you did.
Yeah, it worked out pretty good. And so scholarship, what does that mean?
Yeah. Hey, but you're a perfect example of that, you know, where the fraternity helped you kind of mold yourself and build yourself into a thing that your scholarship was uplifted through the things that you've seen in the fraternity or the example that you wanted to set for those that come behind you. So when you think of scholarship, you think of someone that's dedicated to a certain thing, education being that thing. You know, you think about our kids and how they're going through that transition of being in college. Some of them graduated from college, but the example that we set, that's how scholarship plays an important role in that, I think.
And so, Dan, before we talk about perseverance, I need to go down to 12,000 feet and call Memphis Center.
Yeah, well, let's get to 12,000. We don't want to make no accidents or
things happen up here. Hold on a second.
Memphis Center, Polaris 567 Echo Romeo. We're with you at 160 down to 120 Echo Romeo.
567 Echo Romeo, Memphis Center, right? National 10-3060.
30, 60 on the meter, Echo Romeo.
So, you know, scholarship, it's really interesting that neither of my parents graduated from high school, and through scholarship I was able to graduate from college. And so, but they did grow up in a different time. But let's talk about our last principle, our third principle, perseverance, and then we'll speak quickly about it, uplift.
Okay. Well, you talk about perseverance. That's just going through and transitioning through whatever you're in. You have to persevere in order to succeed. And this may be embarrassing to you, but probably not. But here's what I'm talking about. Perseverance. You think about a person like Daryl Freeman, who I've known basically all his life. He's persevered through a lot of different things. Even in my life, you know, I grew up in the projects. I persevered through that. But I went on to college, and I did what I needed to do. Great, I wasn't the best student. But again, those skill sets that I've learned throughout the fraternity and in college helped me persevere through the things that I'm going through right now.
Yeah, so perseverance is sticking to it, being persistent. You know, that is one of our principles, and it's one that's near and dear to my heart. We've all been through some difficult times. And having that principle helps us to stay focused, stay on task, and to go through whatever obstacle or over whatever obstacles there are. And the last principle is uplift. That's you know, kind of lifting as we climb. And that's a principle that's very near and dear to my heart because I can't forget where I came from. And there are a bunch of people who are trying to come out of certain negative circumstances and situations. So uplift. Is a principle that that's near and dear to my heart. And if you give me about 30 seconds on that, we can close this conversation out.
Well, hey, uplift is really about, you know, like say being a role model and an example, and never forget where you came from. Somebody helped you up, so you ought to be that example for somebody else to pull them up, to help them get not only what you have, but more than what you have. That's what uplift is to me.
So here in the cockpit, Daryl Freeman, Dion Allen, two members of Omega Psi Phi fraternity, two members of the Mighty Mu Zeta chapter, talking about manhood, scholarship, perseverance, and uplift, and how great our fraternity is. And so signing off right here, Rudaroo.
It's to you.